Coming into this game, the Celtics are averaging 113 points a game. Their opponents, 107. The Celtics, of course, are coming off the loss yesterday at Los Angeles against the Lakers. A weird game. They were down by 20 at the half, had that brilliant third quarter to come from behind and go ahead. But that expended so much energy climbing that very big hill that by the time they got into the fourth quarter, they just flat ran out of gas against the Lakers, who had more of a bench to throw in against the Celtics and came out with a win. Gilliam has only played 19 games this season. He missed the early part of the year with an injury. Bird, who's continuing to play superbly on this trip, was fouled by Eddie Johnson, and Larry will go to the line to shoot two. The Celtics matchup situation in this game, a big, big edge for the Celtics up front. Outside Humphries, and a rebound by Kevin McHale. Gilliam is 6'9", 245 pounds. Bird winds up, buries it.
Bird's going to have a big one tonight, I think. Coming off a soft one in L.A. yesterday, I'll tell you, they put everyone but the ushers on him. Double, triple teamed him.
8-6, Celtics are leading 8.5 minutes to play first quarter. Bird has 4 points, now make it 6.
It's flowing for Bird
tonight. Well, isn't it? Now every three-pointer he hits for Bird on the block of Eddie Johnson's shot back into the hands of Adams. Ainge, and every three-point shot he hits the rest of the season will increase his own NBA record of three-point hoops. He hit 92 and 93 yesterday, breaking the old record of 92 set by Darryl Griffith. So Danny will get, about 35 more games in which to work on that record that he's going to establish, that he already has established. Bird with another jump shot, flowing very smoothly for Larry. He has 8 points in the Celtics lead, 12-8.
I'll tell you, if Gilliam is their only inside threat, they're going to be in trouble because he's been able to do nothing. Just doesn't have the moves yet. Takes up a lot of room, big, strong kid, but just doesn't have the offensive moves to create baskets for himself or good opportunities against McHale or Bird, DJ from outside.
14-11, Bird, oh, what a path to the basket. I mean, Larry saw that. His eyes go wide as saucers.
I'll tell you, he's turning Johnson every way but loose. I mean, this kid doesn't. That time he's giving him room, and Bird still blew by.
Three-point play by Johnson makes it 16-14, and Larry Bird rattles in two more, and it's 18-14, and Larry has 12 points in the first quarter. Celtics lead 20-16 after the two Nance free throws. Nance is a 21-point-per-game average scorer, along with another 10 rebounds. There's McHale scoring from low for only the first time in the game. His first basket. Bird for the Celtics still has Eddie Johnson on him. Now, Gilmore came out to set a pick. Did not roll, so Bird banks it home. 14 points in the quarter for Larry Bird.
Nice defensive play.
35th block of the year for Larry Bird. Humphries from out. Rebound McHale. Celtics really taking good care of the rebounding tonight, not giving Phoenix many second shots. Bird for three.
He feels it.
Boy, is he smoking. Larry has 17 first quarter points.
Good foul by the Suns. There were 6 seconds left. Could have created a shot. Be a little tougher
three
to do with one, but
he
Bird
it
does it.
Another three for Larry Bird.
Oh, boy.
Hit 2 3-point hoops in the first quarter. Larry scored 20 points in the first 12 minutes of play.
Great shooters, you know, become even more effective when they know that that you can't put the defensive pressure on them. And, well, now he's got Sanders. Let's see
Gilmore
how long Sanders works.
Good work. Right over the Phoenix backup player who just checked into the ball game for the Suns. Bird at 20 in the first quarter. There's his first two of the second quarter. Larry's only missed one shot tonight. McHale and now Bird. Larry has 22 points. Looking for 24. Oh, he missed a shot. Wait a minute. What's wrong?
Well, I got,
oh, he got fouled.
Good,
okay.
Foul.
Okay. Well, Larry will go to the line to shoot two. 4:20 to play. First half. Celtics leading by 10. Have led it all the way. McHale weaves in. Gets the two. And was fouled, and the basket counts.
The offense, you know, has been flowing so well. Well, obviously, Bird's had such an exceptional night so far.
Bird, 26 and a half for Larry.
Well,
Akers is in, by the way, and Gilmore is down for a rest.
Point guard isn't their problem. They obviously need consistent inside help, but as we
nice
told you, Edwards, yeah. McHale, they're not tapping down for some reason. And, you know, the young, what was he, the second pick in the country last year.
Bird floating it to McHale. Great pass. A great pass from Bird to McHale. DJ.
DJ with a nice release. 6 points for D.
So it'll be Boston ball with 7 seconds to go in the half and lots of time.
Why don't we give it to Bird?
Might as well. He's hit a couple. They do. Larry fires it. 20.
Yes.
29 points. A three-pointer for Bird. 29 points in the first half for Larry Bird. And another incredible performance for old number 33.
I'm glad they listened to our advice. Not that it was particularly necessary.
Ainge. No. Bird rebound. Larry Bird says, all right, let me take matters into my own hands here. Nance doing a pretty good job of keeping McHale away from the ball. Larry matches his uniform number. They've got it down to four. Celtics lead 73-69. Celtics led by 17 at the half. Bird through the middle. 35 for Larry Bird.
Nice little weak side pick that time. Creates the 16-footer for Bird.
McHale into the lane. Gets it to roll.
That does.
Kevin is really doing a job down low with some heavy pressure from Nance and Gilliam, who are just squashing him every time he gets the ball. Mini field for the Celtics. Now Lojas. Bird. Celtics leading by two.
Isolation.
Larry, baseline. He's got it. Congratulations, Alan Perlin of Norwood, Mass. You win a color TV and a Celtics jacket as Larry Bird gives the Celtics a four-point lead. Larry now with 37 points to go with his 10 rebounds. Phoenix has tied it for the first time. Bird does not get the hoop, but he did get fouled by Larry Nance, and so Larry Bird will go to the line to shoot two. The free throw by Bird gives the Celtics a lead of 92-91. Larry has 40 points, goes to the basket, and is fouled, and he'll be going to the line. And right now, that free throw situation really playing in favor of the Celtics. 2 minutes left to play in the game. Celtics lead by three. They double-team Hornacek. Finally gets it to Davis. And now Eddie Johnson for three. And the game is tied. The Suns have hit 4 3-point shots in this game. 100-100. Minute and 38 seconds to go. Bird trying to post up Johnson. Gets it to DJ. DJ trying to post up Davis. Goes over him. No. Rebound. Loose ball foul. Dennis Johnson will put the Suns at the line.
DJ is struggling.
With a minute and 28 seconds to play, Phoenix has a chance to take the lead.
You can get careless on the road and get away with it at home. I mean at home, but on the road it just doesn't work that way. You've got to play the better part of the 48.
So now Phoenix leads by two with a minute and 24 seconds to go. Bird goes around his man, lays it up. Goaltending.
Yes.
Count the basket. 102-102 with 42 seconds to go.
They're trying to keep it from Hornacek. He's the playmaker. He's the one that usually starts it. Celtics want someone else to start it. Now they get it.
Now Hornacek has it. To Eddie Johnson, baseline, whoa, fall away. Suns lead by two. 104-102, 25 seconds to play in the game. There's a 3 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Bird, baseline, lays it up.
Yes!
Count the basket for Larry Bird, and he was fouled. With 17 seconds to go, he ties it at 104. Bird with 48 points in the game. Look at this.
Another incredible performance again when he makes up his mind. He needs the two strong enough to absorb the considerable contact from the weak side, and yet still watch Nance.
Look at that.
Just knocks him out, still maintains his balance long enough to get the shot up to the basket.
And we're tied at 104 with 17 seconds left, and Bird will go for a season equaling high 49 if he makes it. He does. So for the second time this season, Larry Bird has scored 49 points in a game, and the Celtics lead by one. All right, time remaining. There it is, lower right-hand corner of your picture. Walter Davis.
Just isolating Davis on DJ.
Davis, baseline. 5 seconds left. The Suns lead by one. Walter Davis puts the Phoenix Suns ahead 106-105 with 5 seconds to go, and the Celtics call a timeout. All right, here we go.
What they're attempting to do, but I'd stay away.
It's Ainge. Ainge hits the deck.
Foul.
A foul.
Foul call
on Jeff Hornacek with 3 seconds left. Ainge ties it up. 106-106. One more free throw for Ainge. Celtics lead 107-106 on the two free throws by Danny Ainge. All right, here we go. Adams throws it to Eddie Johnson. Fires for three. That's it. Celtics win it by one. Oh, my. This was a tough one. They had to get a 49-point performance from that man right there, Larry Bird. And two free throws by Danny Ainge with 3 seconds to go to win it and go 3-2 on the Western trip.